Hello guys, welcome back to our channel AglaSem Schools. Today, our topic of discussion is Chapter 7, Civics of NCERT book, Markets Around Us. Now, let me explain what does the word market mean. Markets are the part and parcel of our daily lives. Almost everything what we eat, what we wear are brought and extracted from the market. There are many kinds of markets that we visit to meet our everyday needs. These include shops, weekly markets, hawker shops in our neighborhood, and malls. In this chapter, we are going to discuss how the goods reach the buyers, who these buyers and sellers are. Now, let us discuss the question and answers. Question number one, in what ways a hawker is different from a shop owner? The answer to this question is, the basic difference between a hawker and a shopkeeper is that a hawker does not have a permanent shop. A hawker moves from one place to another, whereas the shopkeeper has a fixed and permanent place from where he sells the goods. Another difference is that a hawker sells the good at cheaper rates. Also, the products which are sold by him are not branded. On the other hand, a shopkeeper sells products at a normal market value and at a fixed rate. Weekly markets have a variety of products available at the same place. So, there is a lot of competition, whereas the competition among the shop owners is comparatively less. The next question is, compare and contrast a weekly market and a shopping complex. Answer to this question is, you must have noticed this on your own that a weekly market sells the vegetables, fruits, utensils, footwear, etc. The prices of the goods are relatively cheaper than the shopping complex. The sellers are small traders and the buyers are people living nearby to that area, people with income such as laborers. The shopping complex, on the other hand, sells branded as well as non-branded goods. The sellers are generally big traders selling brands from international brands. The buyers here are the people belonging to the upper middle class or high income groups. The next question is, explain how a chain of markets is formed. What purpose does it serve? Answer to this question is, now a chain refers to the sequence of things forming a line. A chain of market is formed in this manner. A. Goods are produced in the factories. B. Then the wholesalers buy these goods in bulk from factories. C. Then these wholesalers sell these products to various hawkers and retailers. D. Then the customers buy these products from hawkers and retailers. And this is how the products reach the markets. The purpose of the markets are, the chain or markets creates a link between producers and consumers. Second, factories need to sell their products at lower prices. Then, the major advantage of the market is that the goods can be purchased from a nearby place without going to a place which is far from their house. The next question is, all persons have equal rights to visit any shop in a marketplace. Do you think this is true of shops with expensive products? Explain with examples. As the citizens of a democratic country, we are free to go to any shop and buy anything from there. It does not matter that we need loads of money to go to a market to buy a certain product. We can check out the prices of a certain good, and if it does not meet our requirements or pockets, then we can go to the other place to buy that product. Let's take an example to understand this. Suppose your mother went to Phoenix Mall, say in Mumbai, to buy a formal top. She looked at all the tops and none of them were below the price of Rs. 5000, which is actually almost double than the price of the local market. The price did not suit her pocket, which is why she went to another market to buy the top. As a result, we may say our decisions are totally based on how we want to spend on a particular product. Let's come to another question. Buying and selling can take place without going to a marketplace. Explain this statement with the help of examples. The first example is, we all must have heard of Amazon, Flipkart nowadays. And I am pretty sure you guys must have even purchased various products from these e-commerce websites. All these are actually a product of technology. Technology, in a way, has totally changed the notions of buying and selling the products. You can now order something from your home and the product will be at your door in a day or two. These days, even in the hospitals or various medical clinics, you may schedule up your appointments beforehand so as to avoid any chaos when you are actually visiting your doctor. This even helps patients to avoid long waiting hours at the hospitals who are there to seek consultation. Further use of electronic payment modes such as Google Pay, Amazon Pay, Paytm, PayU, etc. have further eased out the process of online sale purchase, that is, shopping without going to the market, turning physical markets into online marketplace. So, this is all for this chapter, Markets Around Us. In case you have any doubts related to questions so discussed, feel free to get back to us by writing in the comment section below. And for other academic support, keep browsing aglasem.com. Thank you.